Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. I am so sorry. If you were in my last life just now and you heard me scream, pardon me. I'm sometimes like that. I'm sometimes crazy. I hate when I go live or when I do my video. I prefer my phone in a landscape position and not in a portrait. I'm so sorry. I don't mean to scare you guys. I don't mean to scare you guys. I'm crazy. I'm like that sometimes, don't mind me. I prefer doing my live stream or doing my video in a landscape position and not in a portrait position. So because I was late, I was trying to meet up with the time and I didn't set the rotation. I'm so sorry, pardon me. So welcome to my live stream, welcome to my video once again, in case if you're gonna be watching a replay of this. So I'm sure you've seen the thumbnail, you've seen the title. So I'm gonna be talking about audience retention today. So guys, please kindly give me thumbs up. I know I really messed up. I'm sorry. I'm sorry, it has not been easy. Holy channel, thanks for coming to my live stream. I appreciate you for coming. I can see one other person there. Please kindly drop comments. I am so sorry. I am so sorry. I don't mean to scare you guys. I don't mean to cut off, and I don't mean to be late. So guys, just pardon me. Yeah, but you're the only person in here now. I know. I understand. Many people have come. Many people have come. They didn't see me, and they were like, "What is happening today?" I hope they come in again. I hope they come in again. You can kindly help me drop a comment for them in the chat so they know I am here. I am so sorry. Oh, I really messed up, I know. But I'm here now. I'm sorry. I'm sorry, guys. I'm sorry. I'm so sorry. Let me see. I think I have two people. Please drop comment if you are in here. Let me know how many people I've got so we can start. I have a very interesting topic I want to talk about today. And I'm sure you guys are. You are ready. You are ready to listen. You are ready to learn. Please, if you're there, drop comment, drop comment, drop comment. I don't want to start and people will start coming and be like, "Oh, what did I miss? Please recap. Please, I'm just coming." You know, I really want people to be here before I start. Wow, I have somebody new in here. Please, if you haven't given me my thumbs up, kindly give me my thumbs up. Thumbs up is free. Okay. Let me see. MC Atomic X, thanks for coming to my live. Welcome, Black Pretty Lady. Give us the gist. I cross my leg the weight. Thank you so much for coming. Oh, I'm sorry. I am for 5 minutes here. I don't understand. Okay, you came in for just 5 minutes. No problem. I understand. Wisdom TV. Okay. I just want more people to come in so we can start. I don't want to start and people start asking, please. What did I miss? What's happening? Evelyn, thank you so much for coming. I appreciate you for coming. Welcome, guys. I'm so sorry. I don't mean to scare you guys the other time. I didn't do the settings well. So when I noticed it, I was like, "Oh Jesus, this is heartbroken. This is heartbroken when I have people already waiting for me. Oh, why will I mess up?" So I screamed. I'm sorry. Oh, for me, I'm doing fine, and I hope everybody's doing great. So guys, we have somebody new in the building. He's new to the business, guys. Evelyn, please help me show him how to fish. His name is MC Atomic X. I'm sure you've seen him there. Show him how to fish. Show him how to, to do the thing. Okay, I think my people are coming in already. Let me see. Let me see. Let me see. Let me see. Khadija Rivins, thanks for coming to my life. I appreciate you for coming. Feb Square, thanks for coming. Pakistani mom in South Africa, thanks for coming to my life. I appreciate you for coming. Okay, kindly show him, please. So you understand. Okay, today we're gonna be talking about audience retention. Yes, I know many people have talked about, "Oh, Susan Dumbuya. Oh, that's my friend. Hey, Bobo Germany, how are you doing? How is your area? Is everybody doing? As for me, I'm fine." Okay, let's start. Today I'm gonna be talking about audience retention. I'm sure you guys know already. You know what, as a content creator, we all know we are up to a task. We all know right from when we talk about your YouTube channel name, for people to notice your channel name is one thing. For people to notice what you're trying to tell them, what you're trying to give them, what you have for them is another thing. So I would like to say the first thing you need to do going for school right now, but my phone rings. Oh, kisses to you. Thank you so much. I appreciate you so much. Okay, the first thing you need to think about is your YouTube channel name. I tell you, you need to consider what you do in your channel with your channel name. It is so much important. Ojugwadeze, thanks for coming to my life. Guys, please give me thumbs up. Give me, I have more than enough people now. I want to resume back to my original self. I beg for thumbs up. Give me, it's free. It's free. My mommies and my daddies, my uncles and my brothers in the house. I'm doing fine. Thank you so much. Okay, your channel name is so important to me. I think if you are trying to have more people coming to your channel, not just them coming, for them to come and stay. Not just the numbers, not just being happy. Oh, I have 50 views, I have 100 views, I have 10k views. That's not the point. How long do they view your channel? That is the main thing. Your views is nothing. You can have 2 million views with just few watch time. So the main thing is, how long do they stay on my channel? How can I make them stay to watch my videos? Number one, your channel name is important to what you do. You can, for example, you can see people who do games, they play games, they do all those kind of stuff. You can see their channel name like Twin Star or Twin something, or they put it as a game name. Okay, you seen that name, you would as well think in your head, oh, what's this person up to? Okay, this person uploads game. Clicking on it, you actually saw the person is into gaming. You can see it gives you like an assurance that okay, this person is able to deliver what I want. And we really need to know that YouTube is one of the search engines after Google. I think I know Google is the first. After Google, YouTube is the next in line, where people go to seek for information, people go to ask questions, people ask crazy questions, I tell you. So you need to really have a YouTube channel that your YouTube channel name, I mean to say, that will attract people, that will interest people. More so, when you tell people, oh, this is my YouTube channel name, it shouldn't be something that is very hard to get. For example, for those of you that are in the group on WhatsApp, you understand what I'm saying. Sometimes I find it difficult to get someone's channel. You can type and you'll find it difficult because there are so many people bearing the same name. And you can imagine, Queen Shella Crystal, thanks for coming to my life. Thank you so much. Kindly give me thumbs up as you come in or when you go out. Anyone, I would so much appreciate it. So you can, okay, let me see. Yeah, click on anyone on this live and then click on the channel, subscribe, and link on the bell. Also view his or her video and make a comment for at least 6. Okay, that's how to connect to the fish. Okay, that's for you, MC Atonic. MC Atonic, that's for you. I already explained to you, but she's explaining better. You click on the icon, you connect to the person I don't want to mention, you know what to do. Then you watch the video for minimum of 3 minutes, drop a comment, the person will understand. Most people in here, in short, everybody in here are content creators. Only few, I think 1% of the people that are here that are not content creators, and I'm sure you are not connected to any of them. I am sure. So start connecting. So they are lovely people, they are friendly people, they're gonna do the same thing. Ify, thanks for coming to my life. I saw your comments on the other live stream. I'm so sorry. I didn't do the settings where, so I have to just shut it down and start again. I'm so sorry. I don't mean to scare you guys. So that is one thing you guys need to check into your channel's name. For example, I use my name as my channel name. I use my name as my channel name because it's like, okay, that's my name. I know I do a lot of things on my channel, but it's not complicated. When I say, oh, hook me up on when I because I do Facebook, I do live stream on Facebook. When I go live on Facebook, I can kindly say, okay, let me see. The Virgin Mom. That's so funny. Oh, I remember that was on your live. Okay, I can tell people, please hook me up on YouTube. My name is Johnson Joy. It's not difficult. It's not difficult, and I choose my YouTube name wisely, so people can easily get access to me. That is number one. Number two, so that it I would rank, not when you are looking for some names, you would see more than 50 names before you get to them. It's a bit complicated. Okay, I'm not saying you should go change your YouTube name. It's just a tips. It's just an advice. Okay, number two way to keep audience retention, to make people watch your videos for longer hour, is the topic. You guys need to learn on how to give topics on your videos. Many people don't know how to give how to put topics. For example, you can't be talking about yes, she made Tisha Kara. I beg you, push you. You people should let me rest on this virgin matter. I laugh and laugh and laugh, and my ribs almost crack out. Eh? You guys are so funny. Okay, you can't be talking about let me see. Maybe you're talking about okay, for example, you can see what I did. I want to talk about audience retention. My topic goes like how to how to do I even remember my topic? Can you imagine something I created? Okay, secret to building your audience retention. You can see it, and that is what I'm actually talking about. So you can't be talking about something else and putting another topic, or trying to deceive people into your video. When you deceive them to your video, for example, people want to come here and listen to how to build your audience retention. Okay, if I put that as a topic and they come in here and I start talking about something else, there's probability they would go out. Not because what I'm saying is not important, but because they came with an intention and they are meeting something else. So it's like okay, you have a very good thing to present to them, but you have a very bad topic. So make sure your topic relates to what you're about to talk to people. Make sure your topic relates to the video. Yes. You don't have to bother. Many people can do the same video. This life is all in rotation. Even the earth itself rotates. So you shouldn't say, oh, because somebody has done the video before, because somebody have done did this kind of thumbnail, because somebody talk about this in their videos. That does not stop you from doing the same thing. That does not mean people would not view. There are billions of people on YouTube that need information, that need quality information. People are on YouTube either because they want information or they want entertainment. Oh, you're welcome, Queen Shella. People, like, I sometimes go to Google for entertainment. I tell you, that's the truth. Anything I tell you is the truth. I will go there to click on celebrity gist because I just want to know what's happening among celebrity gist in America, in UK, in Nigeria. I go there to get information and also to entertain myself. Okay, before I became a content creator, I come to YouTube for entertainment and to learn more, to get to ask inquiry, to know things. Sometimes I can, YouTube, even Google recognize YouTube. Sometimes when you go to Google to say, okay, how to grow your channel or how to cook Nigeria egusi soup, after Google might have displayed how to cook a goosey soup, the ingredient, the article, they would definitely back it up with one or two videos from YouTube. It's normal. That's how it happens. So, oh, Anze, thanks for coming to my life. Thank you so much. Thank you for the thumbs up. Guys, please give me thumbs up. The thumbs up is my fuel. The thumbs up make me feel like, okay, I'm communicating. The thumbs up make me feel like, I'm doing the right thing. The thumbs up give me the strength. So guys, give me the thumbs up, smash the thumbs up, pieces the thumbs up, break the thumbs up. In short, do the thumbs up button anyhow you like it. But don't give me thumbs down. I don't want thumbs down today. I don't want thumbs down today. So, we need to know how to do our things right to grow our audience retention. I noticed of recent, okay, somebody was congratulating me for one of my videos that have 10,000 views. Okay. Yeah, the views. You can see the numbers. I just don't want the numbers. I want people who would really come to my video or to my live stream and watch for like, you know, 20 minutes, 30 minutes. Even when they come and say, oh, I want to watch for 5 minutes and I'm going, I want to watch for 10 minutes and I'll soon be going, I am busy, you know, they would not even know when they watch for 1 hour. That is how it's supposed to be. But there are some things you need to put in place, which are the things I'm talking about. Felicity, thanks for coming to my life. Please kindly give me thumbs up. Okay. I think the next thing on the list is the thumbnail. Thumbnail is also part of what is going to give you audience retention, I tell you. Because you can have a topic that is different from your thumbnail. You should try to make sure your topic goes with it. You guys have noticed me in all my thumbnail with my topic. I make sure when I have a topic, I think in my head, okay, what do I want to talk about today? What do I want to talk about today? Okay, I want to talk about secret to build your audience retention. Okay, my thumbnail cannot be maybe a lady. My thumbnail cannot be a lady standing like this or a lady in a posture without nothing. Or my thumbnail cannot be a flower or something. Even if you want to put flower, if you want to put anything, make sure you put a wording or something that has to do with your topic. It makes people to, you know, it attracts people like, oh, let me watch, let me click, let me see what's going on, let me see what's happening, let me see what she have to say, let me see what they have to say. Let me view this channel. Sometimes I'm not subscribed. I tell you the truth. Sometimes I'm not subscribed to people. Maybe YouTube suggested or recommended a video for me. And I might be seeing many of the videos and I don't click on it. Testy City, thanks for coming to my life. I appreciate you for coming. Kindly click on the red on the thumbs up. When I'm tired, I behave like this. Can you imagine? Rose Arrell, thanks for coming. Click on the thumbs up. Give me thumbs up. Make me feel like I'm communicating. You guys should please give me thumbs up. I'm begging. Five more. Okay. So I've been pronouncing your name wrongly. Really? But I think it's short for me like that. I can say Five Mota Ojo. It's very short. Okay. Your name is Five Mota Ojo. Welcome to my live stream. Kindly give me thumbs up. So you should make sure your thumbnail has something to do with your topic. Your thumbnail has something to do with what you're about to deliver. Your thumbnail has something to do with what you have uploaded. Don't just, you know, make thumbnails. You know, people just make thumbnails and I wonder sometimes, like, what's the topic? What's the thumbnail? Am I sure this person is serious? Sometimes I just scroll away. I don't want to see. Because the thumbnail did not interest me. The title does not interest me. Or sometimes the title interests me, but the thumbnail is off what the title is saying. Sometimes when I see a suggested video, the thumbnail is the first thing I see. And when I check on the title, the title is different from the thumbnail. So I feel like, what am I going? Am I sure I will really enjoy this thing? And sometimes when I click on it, I feel like, oh, no, I don't want to watch. You see? But if you have a thumbnail and you have a title that goes according to what you have to deliver, definitely people want to click. They are eager to listen. They will patiently wait. Even when you do your intro, you do everything, they will patiently wait, you know, to watch and to see what you have to give them. Okay, I think that for that. The next thing we have to talk about is the intro. Yeah, many people have intro on the video. I once had an intro on my video, but I decided to make do with it. Intro is good because especially people who have shorter intro, I think it is more better for you to, like, you know, to have to make sure your intro is not more than some seconds. 1 minute is good. 2 minutes is not too much. But if you have intro that is 3 minutes, in short, 2 minutes, I think it's too long for me because, you know, I click on the video because I want to see what you have for me. You know, when I, for example, I go to how to cook a goosey soup and I click on the video and you are, you know, giving me intros like 1 minute, like 2 minutes, like 3 minutes, I'm getting tired. I'm really getting tired. I want to see how to cook a goosey soup. When I click on the video for how to do a DIY ring light. I really want to see how, I'm desperate to see how to do a DIY ring light. That is why I clicked on it, not to see the intro for 3 minutes, for 5 minutes, for 10 minutes, and I'm sleeping on the video. No, you know, I really want to see what you have for me. So this is my suggestion. I suggest, if you really want to attract people, you really want people to watch a video for longer time, you really want to keep them in there, I think before the intro, number one, you make sure the intro is not too long. Make sure the intro is never too long. It shouldn't be more than some seconds. Number two, that you really need to do is make sure you do something like, okay, I'm gonna do an example of what I think you should do. For example, I want to talk about audience retention, or I want to talk about how to grow your YouTube channel, and my title is good. I titled it "How to Grow Your YouTube Channel," or you know, a very good title that has to do with growing your YouTube channel. And I designed my thumbnail is perfect, but I start by, "Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. If this is your first time viewing me, I'd like you to click on the subscribe button and also click on the bell sign." Or I start I start with the intro. After the intro, I start by saying, "Hi guys, welcome back to my channel." People are tired. They really want to see how to grow their YouTube channel. And within the first 2 3 minutes of the video, if you have not given them assurance, or you are not giving them assurance, you really want to give them what they want, they're going to click off. That is the truth. So I suggest before your intro, you can say something like, "Oh, welcome to my channel. I'm going to be talking about audience retention. And if you really want to know how to grow your audience retention, I would like you to watch this video from the beginning to the end." Then you put your intro. Okay. That 10 seconds of first 15 seconds of the video has given them a guarantee. It has given them a hope that, okay, oh, I'm gonna find the solution to my problem. Oh, this is a perfect video for me. Oh, this is the best. Oh, that's why, thanks for coming to my life. I appreciate you for coming. Kindly give me my thumbs up. You know, it makes them feel like, oh, this is the perfect video. This is what I've been waiting for. You know, but when you start, you talk. Like, you know, you start telling them to subscribe. It's good to tell them to subscribe. It is not against the YouTube rules and regulation to tell them to subscribe, but they really want assurance. There's so many videos about audience retention. There's so many videos about how to cook. There's so many videos about DIY. There's so many videos about fashion. So, for somebody to have clicked your video, they really want to be sure that, okay, oh yeah, this person's gonna deliver what I want. And that is going to make them to stay longer. Because when you let them know, okay, this is, yes, number one, they've seen the title before they click. They saw the thumbnail before they click. I hope I'm communicating. They saw the thumbnail before they click. And now, the first thing they hear from your mouth is an assurance that you're going to deliver what your thumbnail is promising. The first thing they are saying is an assurance that, okay, you are going to deliver to them what your thumbnail is saying. And they are having a guarantee that, okay, this person is going to solve my problem. Yeah, because I said earlier on, we come to YouTube for many purposes. We come to YouTube for entertainment. We come to, you know, to search information. We come to, you know, to learn more. We come to improve our skills. You know, we come to YouTube for many things. We come to YouTube to know information. To some people prefer coming to YouTube than going to watch television. They think YouTube is going to provide, yes, it's 100%, it's accurate, you know. And when they come to your channel and you are making it boring, you're not giving them what they want. Some people might even say, okay, I want to watch this video for just 5 minutes, I want to watch this video for just 3 minutes, and the 3 minutes of the video is not giving them what they want to watch. They're gonna click off. They will click off. This is so fantastic. I have 14 people in the house. Please kindly give me thumbs up if you haven't given me. But if you start your video with an assurance, with something they really want to see, with something they really want to watch, oh my God, I tell you wouldn't know when they'll watch to the end, because they want to know every bit of what you're talking. Oh, Becky, hi. Thanks for coming to my life. It's really a pleasure having you in here. I appreciate you for coming. Please click on the like button. Give me thumbs up. I appreciate you for coming. Thank you so much. So, you know, by giving them all this assurance, it makes them feel like, okay, they are welcome. At the end of the day, you don't even need to preach to them to subscribe. You don't need to preach to them to, you know, to give you a thumbs up of, oh, yeah. She's doing well, he's doing good. You know, they're gonna give you a thumbs up. They might as well even share the video to people who really need to watch those videos. They can suggest your video. For example, I suggest Afrogenic video because I've noticed sometimes you would notice when you go to a live stream, before she start calling out people, she makes sure she make her point clear. Okay, if she want to talk about how to grow your channel, she start a video and say, okay, I'm sorry guys, I might not be able to call anybody, I might not be able to reach out to people, I really want to make my point clear, and she goes straight to the point. So by so doing, if I click on Afrogenic live stream, I'll be like, okay, yeah, I'm seeing what I want to see. I'm seeing what I'm hearing what I want to hear. Do you guys understand that? I'm sure you understand. Guys, please drop comment if I'm communicating. I hate it when I talk and I feel like I'm talking alone. I'm talking to myself. Nobody's dropping a comment. Nobody's giving me thumbs up. Please don't make me sick. Give me thumbs up. Give me thumbs up. Okay. I think the next on the list is editing. Yeah, next on the list is editing. You really need laws. Because we are listening. Okay, no problem. You can listen. Just make sure you catch all the points. And if you are late to the live stream, you can watch a replay so you understand everything I've been talking about. The fourth thing you need to do is editing. Please, everybody who is a content creator need to learn how to edit. You need to learn. I'm not perfect. I'm really not perfect. I'm still learning. I'm still learning. I have a lot of things to learn. But there's some people who really don't know how to edit. I tell you, some people will just do the video. They will do the video and just upload it the way they have done it. I'm not saying it's bad. Yes, it's really nice. Yes, you do your video, you upload it. But there's some little things you can add to your editing that will make people to really want to watch. There's some little things you can add to your editing that will make, you know, that will attract people. It will make people feel like, oh, this is interesting. And when they click on your YouTube channel, they want to watch for just 2 minutes, 1 minute. They end up watching to the end. I've been so trapped with so much. I used to do that before. So why are you not doing it again, Ify? You need to try. Edit your videos. Edit your videos. Yeah, guys, smash the like button. Smash the like button. Smash it. Break it. Pieces it. Scatter it. Don't worry. I won't get offended. Just give me that thumbs up. Give me the thumbs up. So guys, please, there's somebody new in the house. I'm giving him a shout out. He really does not know how to connect, but definitely if you connect to him, he's gonna do the same thing. He's my very good friend. He's gonna do the same thing. He's MC Atomic. MC Atomic X, please guys, connect to him. Anzac, please connect to him. Tess White, connect to him. Everybody in the chat, please connect to him. He's just so new on YouTube. Please connect to him. He's a really nice person and he will be loyal. He will be loyal. He's a loyal person too. Okay, so guys, answer to why you're laughing. Why are you laughing? I'm saying the truth. Let them smash it. I'm not gonna be angry. I'm not gonna be annoyed. Elena Life Design, thanks for coming to my life. I think you're a bit late, but you're not too late. Okay, let me see. I used to upload before without editing. Oh, but now you are learning. Okay, that's good. You need, for example, somebody was asking me, I can't remember who. I think that's iffy. You were asking me, how do I do my videos? I always make you laugh, really. Today, I mean business. Like, I'm serious. I don't want you people to laugh. I want you to learn. I'm serious. I'm not smiling. I'm not playing. I'm not joking. I'm damn serious today. Okay. For you guys that are just coming in, I'm talking about how to Edward Smart, thanks for coming in. I'm talking about the secret to building your audience retention because we just don't want the numbers. We don't want just the subscribers count. I have over 1,000 subscribers. Okay, now I need the audience retention. Yes, there are many things to be to there are many things for you to do to get monetized. It's not only increasing the numbers. At the end of the day, when you get 1K subscribers, what's going to happen to your watch hour? So for you to get your watch hour, you need audience retention. Because I said, why are you laughing again? I'm not joking. We are in the class. We are in the class. Everybody should respect yourself today. If you don't want your teacher to flog you, oh yeah, bring your bum bum. I said, bring your bum bum here. You deserve flogging. Why are you laughing in my classroom? Please, let's be serious. I know Anzette will laugh again. If anybody is not laughing, Anzette is laughing. Okay, guys. You know, after your 1K sub, Ify, you are laughing too. This is a classroom. You need to sit tight, and hold your pen, hold your book, and be ready to learn. Be ready to learn. Don't let me flog you. There is to flog. There is to flog adults too, not only children. Oh, let me see the comments. I laugh too much. I play too much. Don't mind me. I'm never serious with what I'm doing. I'm always playing. Loves, I like your class. Oh, thank you, Felicity. Somebody is sorry. I'm not going to beat you. I'm just joking. So if you're just coming to the chat, you haven't given me my thumbs up, kindly give me my thumbs. Oh, Edward, you are trying to learn. Oh, that's good. That's fantastic. You've missed a lot. I'm quickly going to go back to what I've said so quickly, so people who just came in can understand what I've been saying. So number one thing to number one secret to building your audience retention is your topic. Your topic. You need to learn how to give good topic. You need to learn to know your topic must match what your video is talking about. You don't need to be talking about UK and your I'm not a good teacher. I'm just to help. I'm not a good teacher. I can teach. I can only talk, you know, make people laugh. I can, you know, I don't know. I'm just myself because I'm not a good teacher. I'm so loved. I'm so much love with this, my teacher. It's as if you've known. Okay, it's as if I've known you for ages. Oh, thank you so much. And you're making me to blush. Oh, come and hug me. Come and hug me. And if you don't come, I will vex. Come and hug me. Break my phone. Don't worry. I told you the other time. Break the phone. Come and hug me. Hug me now. Oh, thank you. Don't worry. My screen will not break. Five Mata Ojo, thank you so much. That's the shortest way I can pronounce your name. So don't mind me if I'm pronouncing your name bad. So the first thing is make sure your topic is match what you have to deliver. So you shouldn't be talking about how to do a DIY. Okay, Razorhead, can someone give me a name of free editing? My Movie. My Movie. I use My Movie for all of my videos. No, I wouldn't say all. Because before I get to know My Movie, there's an editing app I've been using. But I can't remember the name. You can see that in the comment section. I use My Movie. That's what I use. But I think other people have what they use. They can also share with you. Okay, so you shouldn't be talking about how to do Bob Marley, like the one I'm doing, how to do braid, like the one I'm doing, and your topic signify how to do a wig, and you say it's the same thing. Hair is hair. No, hair is not hair. When somebody comes to your YouTube channel and it says how to do braid, they really want to see how to do braid. Not when you are teaching how to do braid and your YouTube channel signify how to edit thumbnail, or you put a topic how to edit thumbnail and you're talking about how to grow your YouTube channel. Yes, it is something important. Yes, how to grow your YouTube channel is important. People want to see it. People want to know. Gambia Cousin, welcome to my live stream. Thank you so much for coming. Kindly give me my thumbs up. Okay. You shouldn't be talking about one thing and your title signify another thing. No, it is opposite. What you're talking about might be important as well, but they will not. There's probability they will not watch, because they really they are clicking it because they've seen the topic. They want that title. So you need to learn how to give good title to your videos. It helps a lot. It helps a lot, and it also helps in, you know, for example, it also it even helps in the search engine. You need to know, okay, many people have done videos about audience retention with almost the same topic, with almost the same title. Who's this kitchen? Thanks for coming to my live. I appreciate you for coming. Thank you for the thumbs up. You're welcome to the live stream. Okay, so you really need to know how to give good title to your video. Before giving a title to your video, you need to make sure, okay, go to YouTube, because as I said earlier on, YouTube is rotation. just the same thing as this world we are living, it rotates. It's the same thing people have been doing for 15 years, the same thing people have been doing for 20 years, the same thing people have been doing for 30, 50, 60 years. It's the same thing you want to do. All you need to do is to know how to package yourself. Rebranding. Rebranding your YouTube channel. You know, making it feel like, okay, it's worth watching. Even if I've watched this a million times, I think it is worth listening to this person. I hope you guys understand what I'm trying to say. Okay. If you notice all these Nollywood people that do Nollywood videos, that upload Nollywood home videos, you can see them. This person is going to upload a video. Like, five people is going to upload the same video with different title. But I bet it, the title has something. The title has something to do with the video. So when you're watching it, you will not feel like, oh, I saw this video is what I've watched before. But the title is still signified to the video. That's why you have clicked on it. And you feel like, okay, maybe let me just rewatch it again. The film is really interesting. You are not watching again because it's really interesting. You are watching again because, okay, you click on it. The title is the same thing as what you want to see, even if it's a different thumbnail. I hope you guys understand what I'm saying. So it makes you to stay there and watch. And the second thing I talk about is thumbnail. You guys need to start learning how to edit thumbnails. Some people edit thumbnails so badly, I tell you. I'm not trying to insult anybody. I'm not trying to say I am perfect. I'm just trying to explain what you guys need to know to you guys. You guys really need to know this. Your thumbnail is important. Your thumbnail is important. You know, especially those people who are over 100 subscribers, and you can edit, you can put edited thumbnail. You know, when you're just coming up, yes, you can't put thumbnail. You need to be over 100 subscribers. I can understand. But if you're over that, you need to learn. YouTube is all about learning. Ask questions. Don't feel shy. Don't feel bad. Yes, when I was coming, I asked questions. Though I don't have physical human beings to ask from. I asked from Google. I asked from YouTube itself. I will go to YouTube and start asking questions. How to edit thumbnail. How to start a YouTube channel. How to do this. How to do that. Because I never knew you need to learn. I never knew all these things until when I started YouTube. So I talk about the intro. You need to make sure your intro is not too long. Make sure your intro is not too long. It shouldn't be more than some seconds, just some seconds, minimum of 1 minute. And your intro shouldn't come first. Many people do that same mistake. Their intro come first. Your intro should not be the first thing that somebody would see. Okay? For instance, when I click on your video on how to make... don't mind me if I talk about Nigeria. Nigeria is my country. I'm used to Nigeria. Okay, I want to see a video on how to do Nigerian puff. It's a snacks. It's a round, smooth snacks like this. I want to see a video of how to do meat pie. And you start with your 2 minute intro video. I might as well be tired, because when I search for how to do meat pie or how to bake cheesecake, there are many videos that came. So maybe because of your thumbnail or because of the title, I decided to click on your video. And I click on your video and I see an intro that is 2 minutes, and I really want to know how to bake cheesecake. Or I have some of the ingredients. I just want to quickly refresh my brain on how to do cheesecake. And you are giving me an intro of 3 minutes and I'm bored or I'm tired. I click off and click to the next video. So if you don't want your videos to be click in and watch for just 2 minutes and the people will just go away, make sure you start with what you have to give them. For example, if you want to do a video, for example, I want to do a video. I am doing a live stream on how to increase your audience retention. I might as well start by saying, oh, welcome to my YouTube channel, guys. Today, we're going to be talking about how to increase your audience retention. If you really want to know how to increase your audience retention, I would like you to watch this video from the beginning to the end. Or if you really want to know how to increase your audience retention, I would like you to keep watching. Let's get into the video. You know, it's like giving them the assurance, giving them the rest of mind, giving them the hope that you're going to solve their problem. You're going to you're gonna meet, as in they would enjoy the video. They have clicked on the right video. This is what they really want to do, you know. And for you guys that just came in, you met me talking about the editing. Guys, even if you don't have money to pay for an editing app, there are many free editing apps that you can use in editing your videos. So all you need to do is just to put your head together and learn how to edit videos. It's not difficult. It's really not difficult to edit. You can watch videos on how to edit. You can ask people, you know, they will talk to you about it. They will teach you about it. So that is not a problem. They will teach you what to do. You know, it's very easy. You can ask on Google. You can ask on YouTube itself. You will see videos that are regarding how to edit, you know, with different kind of applications. It's just, you know, it's just putting your mind together that, okay, I want to do this thing and you can do it. I want to do that thing. You can really do it. So, I think the next thing on the list, is how you communicate to your people. Like some people, for example, you would see me when I'm making a video, I face the camera, you know, you don't need to face the camera and be looking like this and be looking like that. Let me see. Lots of love, Felicity. Okay, you don't need to face the camera and be like this and be like that, you know, looking up, looking down. I know some people are camera shy. Yes, it's normal. Some people, they can't face the camera, they are really very shy. But you know, you need to concentrate, you need to focus on the camera. So it seems like, for example, I am looking at the camera, it seems like I'm looking at you and you. So I'm concentrating on you. I'm trying to catch your attention. I'm trying to look at you like from eyeball to eyeball. It makes me, you know, it looks like, yes, I'm communicating. So somebody who is watching will just sit down, you know, like what my brother have said. He said, my leg are crossed. I'm listening to the gist. So he really wants to listen. And I make sure, you know, I'm focusing on the camera and I'm concentrating on what I'm saying. I'm not like, sometimes I do the same mistake too. It's normal. You know, we are not all perfect, but we need to start learning. We really need to start learning, you know, how to you know, you focus on the camera and you make your point known. It is normal. Sometimes people do two in one video. They merge two videos together. I do the same thing. I think when I talk about, there's a video I did that I talk about two things together in one video. Yes, it is normal. People do it a lot. But you can't. I know that there are probabilities that, yes, your topic can match the two videos at the same time. But sometimes it is not possible for you. It is never possible for you to, like, you know, to merge two topics together. It's either, okay, maybe I want to talk about, maybe I have a breaking news, because I do breaking news. Maybe I have a breaking news I want to share with you guys and I want to merge two videos together. Okay. Make sure the first thing you talk about is what your title indicates. Because you want to merge two videos together does not mean you give a different title and you start with a different video. I'm a good teacher. Oh my God. If I go to an exam, oh, I know I failed already. Oh, I'm a good teacher. Don't be kidding. I'm just here. I hope so. Well, if you can understand what I'm saying, you can digest it, you can sit and think. I think it's fine. But I don't think I'm a good teacher. I don't think so. I don't think so. I'm trying. I'm trying to be good. I'm trying to be perfect. It's not my way. But YouTube got me all along, so I'm here. Okay, you know, you should make sure the first thing you are doing, the first thing you are talking about is what your topic or your title indicates. So, okay, they would sit down and watch. At the end of the day, you can switch. I do that sometimes. When I go live, I have a particular topic I want to talk about. I talk about my topic. I make sure people understand what I'm talking about. And after I'm done giving the information, I do what? I switch. After I'm done with what I want to say, I switch. It happens. It's normal. Okay, I am here talking about how to retain your audience retention. And I want to do my live stream for 2 hours or for 3 hours. I can't sit here for 3 hours and talk about audience retention. But I must make sure before I switch or talk about something else, I must have been able to make my point clear. so that in case if other people are gonna come, yes, it's normal. Everybody's not gonna watch your live stream at that particular time you are doing your live. Some people would come, some people would go, some people would not even come, some people are busy, different time zone. Some, like Feb Square, she said she's going to school. Can you imagine? It is, I think, what's the time? It is 10:20 p.m. here. Yeah, that is 23:20 p.m. I think in Nigeria right now it is 9:30 p.m. In UK right now, I think it is 9:30 p.m. In America, it's a time different zone. In Canada, it's a time different zone. In North California, it's a time different zone. So, in UAE, it's a time different zone. So, you need to know that. You need to really know that, okay? You have different people watching. You have different people subscribed to you, I mean to say. And yes, different people is going to come and watch your video. So, you need to consider when you go live. You need to consider people who would come and watch the replay. That is why sometimes you see me when I start my live stream, I start with, okay, welcome to my live stream. If you are watching the replay, welcome to my video. I put that. Because I know everybody's not going to watch immediately I'm doing the live stream. Some people will come and watch later. So what's going to happen to those people? If I just communicate and concentrate on people who are watching right now, what will happen to people who would watch later? They might click on it and they hear, okay, she's talking, she's making some sense. She's talking about some things I think is good. But, oh, she's just talking to the people who had watched before. And when they watch for like 1-2 minutes, they click off. Because, yes, you did the live stream. You have a good audience retention. But what about people who will come and watch later? That is why sometimes when you do live stream, your views would remain the same. Your views would remain the same. I've done my statistic and I have checked. Some of my live stream, the views never increase. They remain the same. And if it would ever increase, maybe 2, 1, 3 people. And small views, just little views. I mean little minutes. I mean to say maybe they watch for 3 minutes, 2 minutes and they are gone. But there are some of my live stream, I tell you. People would come to my live stream and people that came to watch the replay, I would see, okay, yes, they really watched. They watched for like 10 minutes, they watched for 15 minutes, some watched for like 20 minutes. Okay? I hope you guys understand what I'm saying. They really watched because, you know, I'm trying to carry everybody along and not just my audience, not just the ones that are watching at the moment. So when you go live and you have a very interesting topic to talk about, make sure you try to like talk neutral. Talk like you are talking to everybody. You know, talk like you are doing it because apart from people who put their live stream, like me, I don't private my live stream. After each live stream, I leave the video to upload so other people can come watch. So other people can come to benefit. So I don't private it. So I make sure I talk about a topic. Some people do live stream without topic. They just do live stream. You don't know what they... You know, there are many people doing live stream and there are many reasons for doing live stream. Some do live stream so you can come and connect with friends. Some do live stream, you know, to lecture you. Some do live stream for entertainment. Some do live stream, you know, so you can come and interact and learn something, talk about something. Like me, for example, I do live stream and I talk about specific topic. I have topic for each live stream. After my topic, I might as well divert. It's normal. You can't be talking about one thing for 3 hours, for 2 hours. It's not possible. So unless you just want to talk about what you have to talk about and you end the live stream. But for example, for me, I find it like a bit rude when I have like 5 people, 8 people, 10 people in my live stream. And because I'm done with the topic, I end it. No. You try to engage people. Engage them to talking, you know. Say things that will, you know, that would engage them, that will make them talk, that will make them to want to watch more. Yes. That's what you need to do to detain your audience retention. Not people who just come, they watch, they get the information, and they're gone. No. People who would watch and still stay, they would hang around. They would be asking you, when are you coming live? We want to see more. We want to, you know, just try to engage your audience. So, I think that's all for the audience retention for now. If I have any other information to share with you guys, I would definitely do that. If you are watching me and you are a Boroboro, you just came to get the information, you are not yet subscribed to me, kindly click on the subscribe button. Don't hesitate to do that. Join the family. We are full of love. We are full of positive vibes. And click on the bell sign so you also be notified when I go live or anytime I do a video. So I upload a new video. So that's all for audience retention. Guys, don't forget. If you haven't written it down, get a pen, get a book. You need to make sure you start you have good titles for your video, good thumbnail, beautiful thumbnails, attractive thumbnails. Like for people who do cooking, that's right. I don't know if you are still here. You do cooking. You do cooking a lot. And I love your cooking because they look delicious. But your thumbnail, I watch your video because I know you are a good cook. And I watch your cooking videos because you know how to explain. You explain like every ingredient. You tell me why you are using fish. You tell me why you are using meat. You tell me why you have small quantity of stockfish. You tell me why you have spinach instead of bitter leaf. You give me reasons why you have those things. Okay, I want to watch because I'm enjoying the video. Not some people who want to, they do cooking, they'll just be there. Okay, I cook this. They'll just be there doing the cooking. I want to teach how to do donuts, or I want to teach how to bake cake. And they just say, okay, this is the flour, this is this is the that, blah, blah, blah. They don't give you the measurements. They don't interact with the people. They are just too serious for my liking. Definitely, people might not watch. They will just click off because I want to learn how to bake cake for the first time. I saw your video. I want full detailed video. I don't want a video that will just teach me how to bake cake. And after the video, I'll be asking myself how to bake cake. How? After I just watch a video. So I want a video that will tell me, okay, if you want to make this size of cake, you have 1 teaspoon of butter. I'm not a baker. I can't bake anything. I can only bake lasagna. That's the only thing I know how to do. I can't bake cake. Okay, I. Tessie, you have passed promoted. Exactly. No, I tell you, Tessie will tell you. She will tell you why she's not using bitter leaf. She will tell you, okay, bitter leaf is good. You can use bitter leaf. It's optional, but she will tell you why she's not using it. So you will not feel like, oh, but I've seen videos of how to cook egusi soup. They use bitter leaf. Oh, why is she not using bitter leaf? She will tell you before you ask her. She's gonna tell you. So I think she's trying. She's trying a lot, but all she needs to do is, to like create beautiful thumbnails. I'm blushing. Oh yeah, that's the truth. You know me. I would say what I feel, what I think is right, and the truth. All you just need to improve on is your thumbnail. Is your thumbnail. You are trying a lot, but you don't edit your videos. That's one thing. I don't think you edit your videos. Even if you, my madam, I know, yeah, you are right. Exactly. That's the truth. You need to start editing videos too. I think that's why. That's why the editor, she edits her video. Johnson, for real, you should be studying. My God, come here, cousin. Please, you need to tell me why you make this statement because I have heard this statement in my lifetime, like since when I was small, since when I was very little. People tell me, oh, I don't know why you are into nursing. Why are you not a law student? Why are you just be a barrister? You win so many cases, and I feel like no, I am not. I can't be a barrister because I would say rubbish in the court. But I can treat patients, I can talk to patients, I can lecture patients, Many people have this gift to talk. Yes, I talk a lot. I talk like I can talk for hours. I'm not tired. All I need is my bottle of water. This is my and you guys. But when I go to the court of law, I'm gonna fail woefully. If you're just coming to the live stream, please drop comment. Let's know you are in here. Gambia Cousin, please. I really want to know why you think I should have studied law. Because everybody told me this. All my life I've heard, oh, you should have studied law, you should have studied law. Why? Why do you think so? Because I talk too much, I guess. I know. You guys should not blame me. that's my nature. So that's why, please try to improve in your editing. Oh no, in your thumbnail. Make it more beautiful. When you garnish the food, like Gambia Cousin is so good. I tell you, she's so good in thumbnail. She's trying. She's really trying in thumbnail, I tell you. Even sometimes for a long time I might not watch a video, but anytime I want to watch, I will just see number one, number two, number three. Oh, I want to watch everything. Because when I see the thumbnail, I'm hungry already. I want to eat it. Like I'm seeing one right here, how to make a mussel sauce. Sorry, don't mind me. If I don't pronounce it well, pardon me. I can see it. Look at the salad or something at one corner. Look at the sauce at one corner. But my last thumbnail was okay. Yeah. It's nice. You see? This thumbnail now is pushing me to click on it. I want to watch. I can see salad. I can see the sauce. I feel like seeing it in real life. I feel like eating it right now. And I'm hungry. I'm hungry. There's some thumbnail that will make you watch to the end. You can see. Yeah. I see the one I'm seeing the one you did 4 months ago. How to make white jollof rice with fish. Can you see the thumbnail? So beautiful. Oh, thank you so much. You are very good in explaining yourself and full of confidence. Thank you so much. You know, yeah, I'm going to say something about that. I'm not a shy person right from when I was small. So, I learned to be more confident when I went into nursing. Because I wasn't shy, but I am not confident. Because people look down on me because I am short. They tell me, oh, you are too short. Oh, shut up. What do you have to say? Oh, keep quiet. You're stupid. You don't have anything upstairs. What do you have to say? We don't want to listen. So I feel so bad because I don't have the height. I don't look attractive. I don't look good. I feel like I'm so ugly. You know how African people can behave. They look down on you. They take you like you are shit. They take you like you're nonsense. So when I went into nursing, and I learned that, okay, only say, come, let's go. I'm not joking. When I mean I am short, I'm telling you, I am not tall. You can see me. I'm a short young lady. I'm not even, I don't know, what's my height? I don't know my height. I tell you, I'm not joking about it. When I tell you something, believe me. Did you see my height? I'm just, you see? I'm not tall at all. So people, they look down on me so much. But when I went into nursing, but you're pretty. Oh, thank you. Thank you so much. I appreciate you. But when I went into nursing, okay, I got to know, number one thing you need to put in is confidence. You need to be sure you know what you're doing. You need to assure people that you can take care of them. They laugh at you. Can you imagine? Let them keep on laughing. Tell them that the tall people, what have they achieved? Okay. My achievement matters to me, not my height. That's what I tell people. My friends who mock me then, there's a particular guy, I don't want to mention his name. Because one day, even if I mention, you don't know him. He's my friend. He's my childhood friend. His name is Emmanuel. My very good friend. He's a boy. He's a man now. He's grown. He's getting married soon. He's a man now. Okay. You are not short, my dear. I tell you. People, they look down on me. And when he tells me, oh, you are too short. Sometimes when we are walking, he say, oh, I can see the middle of your head. I can see your head. Look at your skull. And I feel like I don't talk. Okay. When I went into nursing profession have made me to know that you need to be confident. You don't need to shiver. Even when the emergency, let me see, Gambia Cousin. Don't kill me with laughter. Height is not important. Just believe in yourself. My dear, oh, if people start talking about height, you'll feel like killing yourself. I tell you, It's just like when they talk about fat people, I have something to say about that. For people who are trying to lose weight, fat people, you know, yes, I know being fat is not healthy, being fat is not good, but you don't need to see somebody and say, oh, you're too fat. You don't need to see somebody and exclaim, oh, my God, look at how big she is. Somebody might commit suicide for your statement. Somebody might feel so bad for your statement. So I think everybody needs to start watching the way they talk, the way they approach people. I tell you, I was once a victim because I am short. I tell you, this is the truth. It sounds stupid, it sounds funny, but I'm telling you the truth. I don't like to stay where my friends are. When I see tall people, I try to stay away from there so they don't know how short I am. Sometimes when I'm in the park, I see short people, I quickly sit down so they don't see me like I'm short. I tell you, I know that feeling. You always look for heels. I have so many heels. Even when I come to work, I bring my heel. It's right there. It's for the winter anyway, and winter is going. I brought my heel because I know maybe one day I want to go out and I need my heel. Okay, let me see. You are too beautiful, and for a lady, you are tall. Oh, thank you. People say I'm short, but I don't mind them. I live my life to please myself and not to please anybody. So if you think I'm not good enough, I think you're the one who is having a problem to understand me. I tell that to my fiance every time. I tell him, I say, anybody who thinks I'm not good enough, I think I ask him a simple question. Do you understand me? Yes. Do you love me? Yes. I'm sure you've known me. Yes. I'm not a troublemaker, Abby. Yes. Okay. If you can understand me and some people are not understanding me, I think they are having a problem, not me. They are having the problem, not me. So I learned to be confident in nursing. I learned to know that you have somebody's life in your hands. Yeah. When someone is sick and they come to the hospital, they trust you for them to come. The same thing with YouTube. It's just the same thing. So it's just like I have learned from nursing and I'm applying it to YouTube. Okay. Let me see that comment. Let me see that comment. 5 feet 7 inches, I think. In, but when I was in school, all my friends were short, and I was the tallest one. And they used to make joke of you. Really, it's not only you. Make real joke of me, but I tell you now, let somebody come and make joke of me. My mouth is not good. I will not insult you, but the savage answer I'm going to give you will either laugh or verse. And when you verse, I will still tell you, are you versing? Don't verse for me, oh. Are you versing? Don't verse for me, oh. So guys, if you're just coming in, thanks for coming in. I saw one thumbs up. I'm so sorry we really talk about what I have to say. You can still join the chat and watch a replay later, so you can really learn how to increase your audience retention. Thank you so much for coming, guys. I appreciate every single person for coming to my life. So when somebody comes to the hospital, they really trust you. They believe, okay, you can take care of me. My life is in your hands. Okay. You see people coming to the hospital and they'll be asking questions like, are you an RN? What qualification do you have? Are you a BSN? BSC in nursing. Yeah, BSN too. Are you a BSN? They ask questions like, in America, in UK, where they are LNP. Oh, officially RICC Berry, thanks for coming. You are looking gorgeous and funny. Oh. Thank you, that's me. So guys, you really need to watch a replay too, so you can catch up with the real Coco, with the real information. Edikesh, thank you so much for coming. Kindly give me my thumbs up. Official RICC, if you haven't given my thumbs up, please guys, give me thumbs up. I am begging, I am begging, I beg, give me my thumbs up. Okay. And I'm sorry you've missed out with the topic. You really need to watch a replay so you can benefit from the live stream. How many years did it take for you to study nursing? Well, I'm actually a nursing assistant. Yes. But I'm looking forward to get my RN. But it took me 2 years to be a nursing assistant. Yeah. But you know, nursing assistants in Africa is different from Europe. In Europe, they have the two badge. They have the batch of nursing assistants that just help patients, and they have the higher batch that set line, give IM injection, give IV injection, and they can't do nothing less than that, administer drugs. Yes. So I think I fall into the second batch because in Africa we have just one batch and they teach everything. They teach everything. I can proudly say I know how to do circumcision. I know at least 95% of what has to do with delivery because, African, their way of teaching with European style is different. European, they teach it batch by batch, but in Africa, they do it all together. So I learn everything together. So that's it for that. Okay. They teach you to be confident. You don't have to be shivering when there's an emergency. Like, for example, you see someone bleeding. You need to be confident. Even when there's an emergency, my doctor will always be like, "No, you don't need to be like this. You need to calm down because if you don't calm down, you'll not be able to talk to talk to the people who had brought the patient in. Oh, calm down, everything is in order. You need to have that look on your face." So that is what I've been helping me with YouTube. So I didn't learn how to be confident. I didn't learn how to be okay. Exact same year in the US. It takes you 4 years to complete it. Can you imagine? You see, it took I 2 years. It's supposed to be 3 years. It takes 3 years in Nigeria, but I have the experience for 1 year. I had the experience for 1 year before I decided to go to go and register and start it and do everything. So that was why I was able to beat it around with 2 years. I got the experience already. Well, okay, what do you want to start teaching me? Will you put me in the class with people when I'll be there doing what? Like I'm doing rehearsal of something I already knew before. Okay, it's fine, but I did it for 2 years and I have my certificate as a nursing assistant. Okay, I learned it there. I learned to calm patients down. I learned to talk to patients why they need to take their drugs. Even patients who are on lifetime drugs. I have an old woman. An old woman, excuse me, pardon my manners. I have to plug this phone, okay? I have an old woman, she's a diabetic patient. She's I think as of then, she's around 65 years old and she's still alive till now. Okay. If you're just coming in, thank you for coming. I think you really need to watch the replay to learn about the audience retention because we are far done with the topic. But you can still join the conversation. Thanks for coming. I appreciate you for coming. So, Mama, she's an old woman, so we call her Mama. She's a grandma. So we say Mama. Anytime she comes, she will be like, "Oh, Mama, I'm so old. Lasheka Brown, thank you so much for coming. Bright Red, thank you so much for coming. Bright Red, please give me my thumbs up. Lasheka Brown, please give me my thumbs up, guys. Make it 23." So Mama will always be like, "Oh, I'm tired of drugs. I take drugs every day. I take in the morning, I take in the afternoon, I take in the night. I feel like I want to die." And I told Mama, I said, "Mama, you know you have children." She said, "Yes." "Mama, you know you have grandchildren." She said, "Yes." "Mama, you know your grandchildren are used to you and they usually come to greet you." She said, "Yes." "And you know when they come, there's a particular dish they want you to always cook for them." You say, "Yes." "Mama, if you die, they'll really miss you, don't you think so?" She said, "Yes, she know, but she's old. She can't continue taking drugs. She want to stop taking the drugs, so she just die." And I told her, "Mama, do you know I love you so much? I'm just saying stupid things just to calm her down and to make sure she take her drugs." She said, "Really, you love me?" I said, "Yes. That's why I always take my time to come and play with you, to talk to you, you know." Left me laughing. Oh, yes, he's a comedian, he's a singer. MC Atomic X is a comedian, he's a singer, he's a really marvelous person. So, guys, please, if you are not connected to him, I'm using this opportunity to give me a shout out. Kindly connect with him, he will definitely get back to you. And he's a loyal person, he's really loyal. Please, I beg you, he's my very good friends. And if I'm loyal, if I'm a nice person, you should know I work with good people. I know everybody's not perfect. Okay, I have to calm her down to tell her sweet things to make her take her drugs. You can see that. So the same thing is what I'm applying to YouTube. I try to help people because it's part of my DNA. I'm used to helping people, encouraging people, even when someone is gonna die. Even when you know, okay, this person will die in 2 months, this person would soon die, this person will die in 1 month. You don't need to make them feel they want to die. You need to. I had been on TV. Thanks for coming to my life. Please, guys, give me thumbs up if you're just coming. I'm so sorry, Ed Abinad. We're really talking about the topic, and it's so exciting. It's so interesting. You need to really watch the replay so you can catch up. Thank you so much for the thumbs up. You need to watch the replay so you can catch up. So we are talking about something different. So that is what brings about when you see me, when I teach people, I can remember. Now I don't practice. I don't practice as a CNA again, no, because I'm in Europe. In Europe, you need to, you need to go to the school. Even if you want to be a CNA, you need to go to a CNA school or go to a school to become an RN before you can operate in Europe. It's different continent, different country with their rules and regulations. Okay, but I remember back then when I was still practicing, when we have the antenata, they comes in, you have them in group, you teach them, you talk to them about, why they need to come to antenata regularly, why they need to take their drugs, why they need to do their checkup, why they have to do their blood pressure before seeing the doctor, the possible signs they would see, the danger signs, why they have to come when they see those signs. So I learned to talk. I talk too much. I talk like every time. You talk to patient ask questions. Some patients, I tell you, some patients are so inquisitive, like they will ask you. For example, if these are drugs, they would ask you, oh, why is this red? Why is the top black? They will ask you, why is this pen black? Why does he have a writing? My God, I tell you, patients, they will ask you questions like crazy questions. You don't need to shout at them. You don't need to be angry. You need to answer them. You need to tell them, okay, madam, you're taking these pills because for you to sleep well. You complained earlier on that you can't sleep, so you need this to sleep well. You need this to boost your appetite. You need this to, to make you eat faster. You need this for, you need to tell them something. Oh, she'll feel like, okay. Don't worry, don't worry, don't worry. If maybe they have 15 pills and she's like, oh, this is too much. Why do I have to take 15 pills? And you start explaining, she'll be like, oh, don't worry, don't worry. Just get me the water. I want to take it. And they'll take it. So I apply just the same thing for YouTube. So don't mind me if I talk. It's part of my DNA. Oh, thank you so much, Edda Binard. MC Atomic X, Edda Binard TV just showed some love to your channel. You know what to do. I don't need to tell you. Do what you have to do. So, guys, if you're just coming in, kindly give me my thumbs up. And I think you've missed the topic, but you can watch a replay so you get along with the topic. So that's just it. That's my nature. Gambia cousin, I think I don't think I can be a lawyer. I'm gonna lose. I'm going to lose. But I think I can be a teacher. You guys say I teach. I don't know. I think so. I think I can be a teacher. It's fair. But I don't want to be a teacher. I would have loved to be a nurse, to work as a nurse midwife. And I would also like to be a nurse practitioner. If I'm able to achieve that in my lifetime, I would be so grateful and so happy because I love to touch patients. I love to, to talk to patients. You are a good storyteller. I can teach CRE. Oh, look at this man. Oh my God. Official RICC. Can you imagine? You guys can crack me up sometimes. Yes. I can tell story because I talk. Don't you just get that? I talk. So it's my nature. So if I can achieve that in my lifetime, I'll be so happy. I'll be like, oh yes, I did it. You will, sweetie. Oh, thank you. I'm gonna share my experience from when I want to, buy my phone, from how I'm gonna prepare for my exams, from my school, everything, my practicals. I'm gonna be sharing this sweet experience with you guys. I'm sure I can do that if I really want to do it. In some years, I'll be able to do that because I love to touch patients. I love, to help people who are sick. I love to touch newborns, I love every single experience. I love it. It's so sweet. If you're not, some people will tell you, I can never do nursing because, oh, I can't pack people's vomit. I can't pack people's pee-pee. Oh, let me see. I like coming back to stream because I enjoy your stream rate. My channel, to me, they do and don't. Oh, thank you so much. Thank you. I'm blushing. Thank you so much, guys. If you're just coming in, kindly give me thumbs up. I can see people coming in. Please support me 100%. Let's be loyal to each other. Give me my thumbs up. Okay, so that's just it. Oh, let me see. Billy Kenny, Bill Kenny. Good activers. Nice to hear from you after a long time. You're looking forward. God bless you. Oh, thank you so much. I appreciate you. Really nice music, I must say. Okay. Are you looking at my eyes? Really? Oh, my eyes are too big. Don't look at my eyes, please. Look at the old of the face. Don't look at my eyes. My eyes are too big. Sometimes I feel like, oh, I have big eyeballs. But it doesn't matter. God has created my eyes to be like that. So guys, don't look at my eyes, just listen to me and look at my face. So, I really don't have much to say. I actually came purposely to do this live stream because I want to share. I noticed something. I noticed when I do videos, excuse me guys, 1 minute. Oof, the room is too hot. I need to switch the heater off. It's too hot. I noticed when I do video, I have lesser view. But when I do live stream, I have more views. That is why you will notice me, the main important topic, I say them in my live stream. Then when I have to do the celebrity gist, when I have to do celebrity gist, latest news updates, any other thing, I do in the video. Because my videos you guys will not watch. But my live stream, you will come. I love you like that. I love you. So you can see that's part of the audience retention I am talking about. You need to know what your viewers want. Give them what they want. You need to know how to carry them along. Carry them along. You need to know how to get them. You can get them. So I think it is it's better for you to. To know, like, people do videos and they have millions of views, they have people watching. But I think it's good for me to do more of live stream because people watch more. So I know what my people want. They don't just want to watch me, like I face the camera, I'm dumb serious, and I talk. Okay. Roll it like I'm acting in a Nollywood movie. No, you don't. It depends. You might be doing that and you're lucky enough you have your views. Oh, Feb Square, thank you so much. But I'm so sorry you've missed a lot. You really need to watch the replay so you can benefit from how to learn how to grow your audience retention. But you can join the conversation. Everybody's welcome to my live stream. You can come. So MC Atonic X, anytime I see your name appear, I remember you are here. I'm so sorry, I have junks on my brain, many things in my head. Connect with people and please do it the right way. When they show you some love, make sure you do the same thing. And watch that video for a minimum of 3 minutes before dropping a comment. Okay, and we love you that way. Your beauty, your storytelling, nature, keep us coming here. And you have got our attention. Oh, thank you. I am blushing. You see, thank you so much. You guys are really nice people, and every day I think like, oh, what am I going to say today? I must talk about something. For you guys coming, it makes me do more. Yeah, if you don't know it, you need to know. It makes me do more. It makes me want to give more. It makes me think. It makes me read. It makes me make research. I search for information. So I come here with something reasonable. Because I know, okay, I know you guys like me because I'm funny. I can't be funny every day. I know, yes, even if I'm funny every day, people will still watch if they want to watch. But I need to do something, something important, something people can benefit from. So I advise you guys do the same thing. For people who have niche, I think it's good. Like Gambia Cuisine, she cooks, and that's what she do. So when I think of I want to learn how to cook something, I can remember, oh, Gambia Cuisine is there. She cooks all the time. This white is there. She cooks all the time. Okay. I know I do a lot of things on my channel. And I make sure I circulate those things. I do health talk. I do latest news updates, celebrity gist. I said that I would do mukbang. But I've not started doing it. I would do it. And when I want to do my first mukbang, it will be with African food. I'm going to sit down and do a mukbang. I'm not going to do a live stream. I will do a video because if I do live stream, your comment will distract me from my food. And I'm an artist. If you want to dance, come see my videos. Okay, no problem. So I'm going to do my fufu. I'm not going to eat eba. No. Gabi, for a long time, I haven't eaten eba, so I don't know. Fufu or amala. You know the Yoruba amala now? I'm going to do amala with egusi soup. There's no way to do here. Well, I'm going to do eba cha with egusi or ogbono soup. Ogbono will make it keep going. Oh my god. I'm sure you guys will enjoy it. If you people do not watch that video, oh, I would come and knock on your door one by one. I have done my video. Go and watch it. I'm telling you because people have been requesting. They say they love me when I eat. Because I eat mostly on my live stream when I'm hungry, I eat. Even if it's 12 a.m., I eat. I'm not scared of getting fat because I know I don't want to be fat, but I need to eat. Okay, egusi soup, I like it, but don't know how to make it. Really? Okay. You can watch videos on how to do egusi soup. But if you still want to watch my videos on how to do egusi soup, I can. I'm thinking of cooking egusi soup next week. Not this week, next week. I'm thinking of, so yeah guys, if you haven't give me thumbs up, 23 thumbs up. Are we quarreling? No, we are not. Please give me thumbs up if you haven't. So I'm thinking of cooking egusi soup next week. You might as well see my own version of egusi soup because there are different ways of cooking it and different ingredients of cooking it. It depends on what you want to use, what you have access to. And it's good. So please, when I do the video, you guys should watch. But I think I'll not show my face. I will not show my eyes. Only my mouth. You guys will not see my face because I don't want to be laughing with the camera. I want to be serious. I'll put the camera here. Only my mouth. And I'll be eating. I will teach you how to prepare egusi soup. Eh? Yeah, guys, show me some love, please. Show me some love. I'll put the camera here and I'll do the mukbang and I'll upload it for you guys to see. So you guys can see how wide my mouth is, the circumference of my mouth. You guys can do the mathematics, do the addition, do the subtraction, do the multiplication and see my mouth. No problem. I'm going to do it. So I do mukbang too, but I haven't done one single video on it, except when I do it in my live stream. Oh, Tosin Creations, thanks for coming to my life. Kindly smash the like button. I've been crying since. I know when you come, you'll give me. I've been waiting for you to come. You are that person that I'm waiting for. Smash it. Smash it. Yeah. Go, girl. Go, girl. Go, girl. Go, girl. I'm waiting now. You want me to shout for nothing? I know you'll give me anyway. I know. I'm just funny. Me? Am I an MC? Okay. You're talking about MC Atonic. I think you're talking to me. No, I'm not an MCO. I'm just a talkative. Don't mind me. So, Tosin Creations, I'm so sorry. I think you've missed the topic, but you can still watch the replay. So, you can benefit. You can really benefit from this live stream. Oh, yeah, I've seen it. Thank you so much. Kisses to you. I blow some kisses to you. I hope you catch them. Catch it, catch it, catch it, eh? It's so warm kisses. Okay, I know you need cold one. Cold one. Africa is hot right now, but Europe is cold right now. Okay. Education. Chineke na gi. This is serious. This is serious. I should sing with this crack crack voice. Do you mean it or you are joking? Paratirigata one, thanks for coming to my life. I can feel that this person is someone I don't know. Let me check. Oh, thanks for coming to my life. I appreciate you for coming. Now I know who you are. Thank you. Thanks for coming so much. Please give me thumbs up. Make it 25. If you haven't done that, make it 25. Yeah, I know it's somebody who knows me off YouTube. Off YouTube, I mean to say. Come on, sis, don't be shy. Me? So you think I am shy? You think so? You don't know me. People that know me, they know me. But you didn't use the right hashtag. See, if I didn't, I would check well. That's true, maybe because I did the first one, but I didn't do the settings well. I didn't do the settings well, so I had to end it in few seconds, and I started this one again. So I was rushing, so because people will be waiting, so I'm sure I have done a mistake or error. I will check it and correct it. Thank you so much. Thank you so much. But it is all well and good. Oh, thank you. I will check it out, Tosin Creations. Okay, Tosin, I saw your Aka and Clara video. Yeah. Thanks for watching. Thank you so much. Were you at the wedding? Because I saw your old video too, though I didn't put comments. It was your own that I saw. Then because I have downloaded it from Facebook. I was like, okay, I'm gonna upload, I'm gonna this. I don't have the time, but when I saw yours, I was like, ah, I said I was gonna do this video. I haven't done it, so I had to do it and put it up there. Okay. What was I saying? Okay, Edike, she said I should sing. My voice are cracked right now. If I sing, I will sing so bad. And my choir mistress is not here. Evelyn. Evelyn, are you still there? Evelyn is my choir mistress. She, you know, we we sing together, but she's not here. She would have been giving me song to sing. Okay, Adikesh, which song do you think I should sing? Don't give me hip hop. I don't know how to sing hip hop. I'm not used to hip hop. Give me gospel. Is it gospel or gospel? Anyone, as far as you understand me. If you're just coming to my live stream, please give me thumbs up and join the conversation. What should I sing? Oh, see, my voice is cracked. Okay, Tosin Creation, MC Atomic X is just showing you some love. Please kindly do the same thing. Why did you delete it, MC Atomic? How would she see it when you delete it? Can I rap? Okay. Hey yo, I have to update the thumbnail. Okay, number one, topic. Number two, thumbnail. Number three, intro. Number four, editing. I'm not a good singer. People should not laugh, oh. People should not laugh. Don't provoke me today. If you bring your bum bum, I will beat you. We are in the class. You respect your teacher and I beg, which baby can sing? People should stop deceiving me. People should stop deceiving. Okay, let's do it like this. Welcome to my live stream, welcome to my live stream, welcome to my live stream, oh, welcome to my live stream. YouTube have finished me. Can you imagine? Edikesh, so you asked me to sing so that you can tell me that YouTube have finished me. I don't know anything again. The only thing I know how to do is to do YouTube. is how she sings. I don't know what to sing. I tell you, I don't know what to sing. You are asking me if I can rap. I tell you, my voice is cracked. You are asking me, I want to rap now. People must listen today. I want to rap. Okay. Welcome to my live stream. Welcome to my live stream. Welcome to my live stream. Oh, oh. Welcome to my live stream. Welcome to my live stream. Welcome to my live stream. Oh, oh. Gambia Cousin, welcome, welcome. Ify, welcome, welcome. Eddie Cash, welcome to my live stream. Bright Red, welcome to my live stream. Yo, yo. Man, I don't worry. I'll go and compose a song for you guys. Eddie Cash, you're not serious. You're not serious. Please, if I don't mention your name, me no verse for me, oh. Fab Mota Ojo, welcome. Feb Square, welcome. Everybody, welcome, welcome. Don't forget to click the thumbs up. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel. Didn't I sing well? My dear, it's not easy. Don't be a cousin, you're laughing. Okay. I will not kill you today. Joy, don't kill me today. No, Allah. The king must hear this. Oh my God. You're dancing. Yeah, yeah. I'm not satisfied because you don't know me. Why will I not know you? What do you mean? Why will I not know you? Do you want me to start talking when I've seen? You can't hide. Eh? You can't. I have headache. I don't think you can hide. Those that have their palm kernel being cracked by Bino Vido. What do you mean? How will I not know you? I better go and say something else. Who told you I don't know you? I know you. It's somebody that know me of YouTube and I know you very, very well. So I know you are. You have come to support me. Thank you so much. I can't sing, Eddie Cash. Please don't give me a difficult task. let me think. My voice is cracked. Let me think of a song. I don't know. If you ask me, now who I go ask? The matter. If he's cussing yo. And now she's trying to help me now. And she want me to sing. I don't know what to sing. The matter where we see, so it's a way you start. No be me go talk, I'm heavy for mouth. If you ask me, the matter for ground, hey, now who I go ask? I go ask YouTube. Okay, it's good. YouTube is a search engine. You can ask YouTube. No problem. Good night, I'm off to bed. Why do you want to sleep now? Why? Let's do this thing together. Let's just get it to 2 hours and I'm good to go. Eh? You don't have appointment tomorrow. Please stay here. Hey, look at my friends are here and you want to sleep. For what I'll just say, go ask Instagram. Okay. I will sing another one through another question. Okay, you guys, who will I ask? I'll ask my mommy. If I ask my mommy will give me a good answer. My mommy is in search engine. She knows many things. She will tell me. Oh, I'll ask my grandpa. Oh, yummy tastic. Thanks for coming to my life. Yeah, everybody's doing great. Yeah, that's Omawumi. Is it Omawumi or Omawumi? My name is Omawumi. I don't know. Omawumi. Thank you so much. Please give me thumbs up. Give me thumbs up. Yummy tastic. Please. I beg you. Give me thumbs up. I beg you. They've turned me to a singer. So you've come in to meet a singer. I'm so sorry. We've diverted from the topic, but you can kindly watch the replay so you benefit from the topic. Now we are singing. And this is my microphone. Okay. What am I singing next? If you do me, I do you. Man, no go first. I'm with you even when sleeping. Vitalist. Okay. Oh. Scatter the dance floor. Man, no go first. Touch me, I touch you. Man, no go first. Man, no go first. Man, that's the good voice. If you do me, I do you. Man, no go first. Step on the dance floor. Baby, give it to me. I will give it to you. Baby, give it to me. I will give it to you. Oh, no. You get a city to me. Baby, give it to me. Now the way you do me. You go window, my baby. Today I'm not feeling sleepy. Why? When you have told me to a hip hop singer, how will you sleep? We are here together. This is my microphone. You try not singing again. Oh my God! I don't know what to sing. You put what to kill. I'm laughing. You put what to kill me. Okay, let's be serious now. You know when I'm serious, I'm serious. Should you guys know? Okay. Let me think. You the verse. Let's make you the verse now. Shoo. Not a verse for me, oh. Yeah, do me, I do you. Man, no good verse. Let me sing this one. If you are you laughing? I'm cooking and hearing you. Oh, thank you so much, Feb Square. I want to sing. I don't know what to sing. Can you imagine? Okay. When the people you see around you is only Jehovah's Witness, you don't know how to sing. I tell you. The only people I see around me are Jehovah's Witness. They are good people. I'm not saying they are bad. But you can never know how to sing again. Eh? Oh. Okay. I should sing. Okay. Let me think. No, that's not good. Oh, I'm eating, and that's not good. Oh my God, what will I sing? 1 minute. Let me just think. I know I will think. I will see this one. I'll see a song. I'll have a song. Sing Victor at Waiting Begin. I don't know how to sing it though. The person that know how to sing it has gone. You know how to sing it. If I not love you, wait here again. If I not eat fufu, wait here again. If I not eat ogbono soup, wait here again. If I not do my live stream, wait here again. If I not make una laugh, wait here again. If you are you, me, I don't like all this kind of thing, no. It's if that is not making me to sing. She's always cutting. Why are you laughing? Eh? He said I should sing. He said. He said I should sing waiting we gain. Eh? How will somebody be singing? You people will be, you just be laughing now. For... Okay. If I not do my live stream waiting again. If I not make una laugh waiting again. If I not eat up on the soup waiting again. If I not, you know, if I not do my YouTube waiting again. Waiting again, waiting again, waiting again. Oh. Waiting again, waiting again, waiting again. Hey, Ada. Oh, don't worry. Then I want to do my wedding. I will invite all the YouTube people. Stop the singing and start. I should stop the singing and start dancing. Okay, no problem. When I want to do my wedding, if I invite all of you, if you don't come, oh, I will come and make a list. All the people that don't come, I will come and give you shout out. Okay. Now it's dancing now. It's no more singing. If you people laugh at my dance step, remember, my pankera is here. I will give you lashes in the bum bum. So don't laugh. Let's be serious. I've not started. I just want to start. Okay. What? Ada. Please, can you remind me the beginning of the song? Because I have forgotten. You know, I have many things in my brain. It's not easy. Please remind me now. Nobody should laugh. Just remind me. I can't remember anything, nothing in my brain. At least this is better. Ah, okay, the dancing is better. Ify, Edikesh, please, I can sing this, all this thing I'm singing. You consider this one as sing, dance shaku, so you want to kill me, now I know your plan. Your plan will not work it in my life, lie. So I should do like this and break my leg. I only know how to fight Kung Fu. I can do Kung Fu, but I can't dance. Please remind me the beginning of that song now. Gambia Kusi, you want to... Talk? They want to turn me to another thing. Oh my God, where's my phone? Don't worry. I will play the other now. So I can remember the song so I can dance. Is it this one? I hope so. No. Joy, you don't have work this night. No. I finished my work, oh, ready to pay my flights. We'll be there live. Oh, thank you. I should pay your flights. Abi, you should bring gift for me. No problem. Everybody is welcome. Oh, Joanne. I just closed, oh, my dear sister. I've been working all day. It's not easy. Ne, children, eh? Children are, if you don't have the patience, you feel like throwing them through the window. I tell you. You see? If I dance like I'm inside the church, don't mind me. I'm a church girl. Have you seen my beautiful lady? Let me see the comments. If you maybe that would be better than singing. Okay. I don't know how to dance. See my beautiful baby. My tomato baby, oh. Yeah. Baby, Safi, they call me Temba. You will get. Baby, na sugar, sugar. Hey, that's truth. Everybody, they wait. Metaka, no, if anyone, Maka, better soup, na nikilamo. I don't want no pick him, yeah. Ada, ada. Ada, ada. That's the end of the dancing because I don't know how to dance. Everybody they wait. Better kela no po. If anyone maka, better soup na money kila mo. I don't want na pick him. Yeah, ada. No worry, na so I go take. No, Don't joke with me, oh. When it comes to my wedding, I will dance, oh. Edikesh, if you want to bet with me, don't worry. When that time comes, I'll let you guys know. We will bet. Come to my own wedding. I've started doing the practice down. All the dance I want to dance on my wedding day. Don't try me, oh. The dance that I've been practicing since when I was 6 years old for my wedding day. All the dance they've danced. I will, oh. All these shaku shaku. All these what they used to call it? Everything. I have done the practical. I want to go and dance and hey, don't try me, oh. What are you trying to say? That you beat me on my wedding? Nobody will beat me on my wedding day. I must be the one to win the day to steal my show. So you come to my wedding, you come and dance more than me. You don't have to do video of. Yes, that's true. Stop the music before YouTube says copy. Exactly. Most of the music now, they are now copyrighted. Though I know some of them that are still not copyrighted, but you understand, Edikesh, you don't understand. How will you dance more than me on my wedding day? You want me to cry? I will dance more than everybody. I'll be the best dancer that day. Even if I don't dance well, everybody will tell me I dance well. And I'm going to dance well. I will dance. So guys, I'm not. Your talent is. Your talent is to talk there, leave the singing and dancing for us. Me, I don't know how to dance, so I'm telling you. Before I know how to dance, I can dance very well. Even people that know me like 4 years ago, they don't believe that I can't dance again. When I say, "Oh, I can't dance," they say it's a lie. Oh, you that used to dance, used to twist, used to whine. I say sorry. My body have stiff. All the bones, they are not flexible again. I can't dance. And now I am not thinking of dancing. I'm thinking of of making cool cash. I'm thinking of many things. I'm thinking of going to school, I'm thinking of getting married, I'm thinking of my family, I'm thinking of many things, thinking of myself, how to enjoy my life, not just to work, how to, any things. So I don't think of dancing again. It's truth now, even Awilo Lokumba, everything. I will dance it on my wedding. Skelewu, MC, let my friend dance. It's way better than singing, really. So I dance better than singing. Don't worry. When I tie my two wrapper, I'll come and do the Igbo cultural dance. I'll do the Igbo cultural dance for you. And they used to be like this. Yeah, that's the only dance I can dance. When I tie my two wrapper with my blouse, I will be in the spirit. You need to. I'm going to do what, Edikesh? I don't know. It's like they send you to me this evening. I understand, no problem. It's like they send you to me now. I know. So I should. That one will break your waist. Africans, West Africa are known for waist dancing. Most of our dances, is it not waist? Let the waist break. If the waist break, I use Aboniki to massage it. Most of our dance are waist anyway. I think Ethiopians, they dance with their neck. Yes, I saw it on one documentary when they were doing like this. I don't know how they were doing it. The Ethiopians. To show my talent now. Which talent? The only thing I know how to do is to talk. You guys say I can teach a little. I think so. I think I can teach a little because I'm used to teaching, but not, facing camera, talking. I'm not really good at that. Okay. But I'm trying. But if I go to France to go and do what? You need paracetamol. You need to go to the pharmacy. Do I look like a pharmacy? Does my body dispense paracetamol? Please leave me alone. Okay, oh yeah, take the paracetamol for my mouth. Does my body dispense paracetamol? You are very funny. To dancing talent, I go and do what? Yes. With the Senegambia dancing is very harder. Can you see? Some dance are really very hard. So West Africa, the only thing we do, I think most of is our ways. I swear, you go make when people are there that they can dance, they can break. They can do like this. So I'm going to go and be doing what? I'm going to be doing. Shakiti, bobo, obe, goosey, yeah, party, over fire, no. What would I go and be doing there? I can't dance. I really can't dance again. Because I don't have the time. I don't play music. I don't have time to play music. When I was a bit younger, when I was in Africa, I used to go to parties. Believe in yourself, not this kind of thing. Something you know you cannot do. Please, don't go and disgrace yourself. Don't disgrace yourself. I can't go and disgrace myself there. No. One of the baddest advice I've ever received. So go to that. With this my stiff leg, my stiff hand that cannot move. Oh no. If you say maybe I should go for another. If you talk about singing, excuse me, singing would have been better because I have the voice to sing. But I've not been practicing. I've not been serious. So, it's possible that my voice have disappeared, and it's a normal thing. It's a normal thing. And if I really want to sing, maybe if I want to sing, I would try to train my voice. I wouldn't stress. I have shouted. You know how many shouts that I shout today? It's not easy to take care of children. I have shout and shout and shout. So my voice is very bad. Even now, I think it's getting more worse. My voice is bad. So my voice is so bad. I don't sing. Guys, if you're just coming and I see two people just came in, please kindly give me thumbs up. And we are done with the topic. You can watch a replay. Well, I look gorgeous, really. Thank you so much. I'm doing good. Thank you. I saw the thumbs up. God bless you. So you can watch the replay so you get what I was talking about, what the title, the thumbnail, what it signified. We've already talked about that, and we're just discussing something different. So guys, I want to ask a question. I'm thinking maybe to do this thing. What's it called? The poll that we do, like, which video do you guys want to see next? Which video? You know, I do so a lot of things. So sometimes you might see my videos and I'm not in the video. I don't show in my video if I don't have something important. Yes, the poll. If I don't have something important to really talk about. Like the last video you saw me in was the video of virgin birth possibilities. Yes, virgin birth possibilities. When I was talking about how possible is it for a virgin to get pregnant? Or how possible is it for you to get pregnant without penetration? It is possible. So if you hear, oh, I got pregnant as a virgin, it is possible. I should sing God's Plan by Drake. Yeah, I don't even know who Drake is. So I can't sing. I'm not singing again. Edikesh, you want to kill me? Yes, exactly. Virgin birth can happen. It can happen. Start practicing it before the D-Day. You mean the dancing? You hate Drake? Really? I don't know Drake, so I don't know him. Probably I know him, but I don't know he's the one because I don't have time for music, I tell you. The only thing I think of every day, this night, when I sleep, okay, we have the YouTube group where we help each other in running our playlist. We have the people who want to run for tomorrow. Before I go to bed, because definitely, what's the time now? It's 11:27 p.m. I'm sure before I almost round up, maybe it's 12 p.m. I start running it by 12 p.m. before I go to bed. Okay. I want to go to work tomorrow. I want to learn French. I'm gonna work, take care of the kids. I'm gonna cook. I think of my live stream in the evening. I think of the group as an admin, you know, to reply messages, to do all those things. My brain is occupied, and you want me to be thinking of Drake. I'm so sorry, I don't play music any longer. When I'm off with the live stream, I think my bed is calling me. I'm going to sleep. Okay, if virgin birth can happen, then Jesus is real. If a human can have a virgin birth, then imagine how much more God can do. Okay, well, I think you need to go and watch that video. For you guys who haven't watched my video about virgin birth possibilities, please go and watch it. This is far beyond miracle. Yes, I know. I believe in miracles. I have seen miracles. Yes, I have been in a circumstance of miracle. Like, wow, how did this happen? Wow, this is a miracle. Yes, I have been in such circumstances. But this is just simple mathematics and simple practical. So you guys need to go watch the video, but I'm just gonna say a little about the virgin birth possibilities. Okay, you can imagine it depends on what you take as a virgin. Some people take the first penetration. Okay, if you have never been penetrated by a man, you are a virgin. Okay, some people talk about the hymen. Is it hymen? I hope I pronounced that well. They say when the hymen is still intact, then you are a virgin. There are some ladies, you have kids, you never told me. Ah, I thought I could have a checky date, that's it, my life is over. You are joking. Oh my God, I don't have kids. I don't have kids. I work with a family who have kids. So I work as a nanny for now to take care of the kids, to cook for the kids, to take them out to play, you know, to do all those things. And it's really very stressful, but I work. Really? So somebody is in the building that I didn't see. Wow. Just saying that, okay, oh, that's our other name. Eni Izina, okay, because I call her Fab Square. When I saw that name, I felt it's somebody else. Why am I worried? I'm worried for nothing. So, guys, if you're just coming in, kindly give me my thumbs up. So, it's just a simple mathematics. Oh, great. So, we can still have a wonderful day, a date that will make you a champion. You are very gorgeous. I love your video. Thank you so much. Don't worry. We're gonna do a YouTubers hangout. So for we within France, we can. I think for now, I am the only YouTuber that is in France that I know. I know there are many YouTubers. That the one I know. I think I'm the only person. So I think I wish I know some people. We can hang out together. You know, pick a location. We go there. We hang out. Sit down. Talk. You know, interact. And see each other in person. You know, it will really be nice. But I think I'm the only person. You're in France, I'm in London. Oh, you're not too far away anyway. You can come through Paris, you can come through Geneva. It depends on where you want to come through. But we're gonna talk that after the show if you really want to see me. Well, virgin birth is possible, it's just a simple mathematics. Okay. It'd be nice to meet you. It's my pleasure to meet you too. Some people consider when the hymen is still intact. They consider that if you're just coming in, we've really talked about the topic. You need to watch a replay to catch on that. We are talking about something different now. Kindly give me my thumbs up as you join the conversation. Okay. When the hymen is intact, they say, okay, you're a virgin. But did you know some women have very tiny hymen? And we just the tip of the finger, it can get ruptured. Exactly, I'm taking. They don't want to understand. Can you see? What is your favorite song, color, and food? Oh, Edikesh. I would say that, but let me quickly make my point known. Okay. With just the tip of the finger, the hymen can get broken. So if you consider the hymen as a sign of virginity. When it gets broken by just the tip of the finger, then you consider yourself as not being a virgin. If you consider yourself a virgin without penetration, like, okay, I've never been penetrated before, I'm a virgin, then when you have your first penetration, you admit yourself as, okay, I'm no longer a virgin. Okay, now this is how it works. You see, virgins that accept the fact that until when I get penetrated, that is when I am no longer a virgin. They can use the method of the fingering method. Oh, thank you so much, Gambia Cousin. Thank you, I appreciate you for coming. They can use the fingering method as an alternative for penetration. Okay, that is good. You see, some people they do the wet umping. The wet umping is when a lady is having her panties on. And the man is just flimpering his penis up and down, or she's having a jean on. She's having a jean on, or her leggings or anything, or she have a cloth that is on top. I hope everyone is great. Oh yeah, I think so too. Everybody is fine. Or she have a wrapper or a piece of paper covered to her vag or something, and the man is using his cock to, like, you know, to play around. Yes, some people can have maximum pleasure by doing that, and they think, okay, I'm a virgin, there's a clothes, I can't get pregnant, or I'm putting on panties, I can't get pregnant. You can get pregnant, and this is the simple logic. Sperm travels in a warm environment like the vagina. So I have the simple logic. When a woman is on and the man is on, the man is wet, and the semen you are seeing has little quantity of sperm in it. So if you don't know today, get to know now. It has very little quantity of sperm in it. So if you say, oh, it did not penetrate, maybe even though either wet umping or dry umping, people do mostly dry umping, but some people take the risk to do wet umping and say, okay, we cross our hearts, we're not going to do anything, just flip it through so we can have the pleasure. and he was just flipping through. If it is wet, it is more dangerous. And even if it is dry, it's not 100% guarantee that as a virgin you can't get pregnant. Or even if you are not a virgin, without penetration, you can get pregnant. Many people don't know this. You need to know. So you can teach your children when they are of age, teach your male children, teach your female children what they should do, what they should not do, the kind of dangerous play they should not play. We have causes of us being so from that. Exactly. So when they flip through, think when the panties get wet, because it's normal, the cock is wet, the vag is wet. And when it continue to flip through like that, up and down, right and middle, center, everywhere, do it anyhow they want it. Remember, the panties is gonna be wet. And the semen which contain little sperm can pass through the panties. It can pass through the panties and get into the vag. And remember, sperm travels so quickly, like so quickly. Once it gets into the vag, sperm travel in a warm environment like the vagina. So once it gets into it, you are there playing and the sperm has traveled already. In 3 days, you have conceived already. And the next month, you are expecting your menstruation, you are not seeing it. And you'll be thinking, what's happening? I didn't have sex. I can't get pregnant. Oh, I'm not worried. You need to be worried. If you're playing around these kind of things, you need to be worried. So you'll be like, oh, I didn't have sex, then I'm not pregnant. The next month, you did not see it. The third month, you did not see it. Before you want to do a test, your pregnancy is 4 or 5 months. So I shared the story of a lady who got pregnant as a virgin at age 23. Yeah, she got pregnant as a virgin. And she knew she was pregnant when she was 5 months gone. I think 4 or 5 months. Can you imagine? Because she was like, oh, I didn't have sex. It did not penetrate. She gave birth to her first child as a virgin because the guy still did not penetrate it. And the guy was wondering, how possible is that? I'm not sure. You know, at a point, he was like, okay, I'm responsible for the pregnancy. At a point, he was like, he's not sure. So there's virgin birth possibilities. We need to start lecturing our children, our female children, not just the female, even the male children. You don't want them to do what you don't want them to do. Don't worry. Oh, thank you, Feb Square. I appreciate you for being here for me. So you really need to let them know their right from their left. If you don't teach them, they will learn from outside. And when they learn from outside, they become more worse. They learn the wrong way. Don't be like African parents that say, oh, I don't want to tell my children because it's wrong. No, it's not wrong. If you don't tell them, that is when it is wrong. Don't be like my parent that tells me, when a man touches you, you get pregnant. And I start running from everybody. I start avoiding people. I don't want to sit down where a man is sitting down because I think that is how I could get pregnant. They didn't tell me the truth. So tell your children the truth. Tell them to be safe so they will not bring an unwanted pregnancy for you. In Europe, you hardly see. I say it every time. And my mom would be like, oh, why are you saying this? I say, yes. In Europe, you hardly see young girls getting pregnant. I'm not saying there is not, but maybe out of 100%, just 10%. You can't see young teenage girls in the streets with pregnancy. Never. Never. It's hard. But in Africa, you see them, children bearing children. 13, I have a child. I'm 16, I have 2 children. I am 21, I have 3 children. Oh my God, Mama Mia, what's happening? Because parents don't tell the children the truth. And once this thing is broken, I've noticed something. It is very hard to say, okay, I don't want to do this, I don't want to do that, I want to stay alone. It's a lie. It's very difficult. That's the truth. Whether anybody's gonna take it or you leave it, it is the truth. That's why you see people, okay, when they have a problem with their boyfriend, they have another boyfriend. Yes, it's true because they can't stay alone, they feel lonely, they want more. So it's better not to be broken than when it is broken. So I think it's better for you to tell your children the truth. If I have my girls at 10, I'll start telling them about their menstruation, when it's gonna come. If you see it in the school, don't get terrified. If you see it in the streets, don't be scared. Don't feel like you are injured. Don't, you know, don't feel shy. Ask for help. You can, Europe is good. You see public toilets, you see all those things. You can get a pad from a store, do like this, do like that. You know, you tell them. But in Africa, parents don't talk to their children. They don't tell their children. They don't tell anything. They don't sex educate their children. Once my girl is 14, 15, I will start sex educating and tell her the truth. You think, okay, when I tell her the truth, she's gonna get loose. It's a lie. She would know what to do. When you tell them the truth, they know what to do, because don't deceive yourself. Don't be like a fool as a mother. Don't be like, they know it already. You are hiding it from them, but they know it. And the information they are getting from YouTube, the information they are getting from their friends might be the wrong information. But when you tell them, when people from outside comes to tell them, okay, oh, sex is good, sex, they'll tell them, oh yes, I know. My mom tells me this, but I think it's better to stay till I get married. And when people, when their friends laugh at them, oh, you're still a virgin. Why are you still a virgin? Oh, I'm no more a virgin. They say, okay, it's fine. It's your life. It's your opinion, but I choose to be, because you've tell them why they should be. Oh, someone is just coming in. Thank you for coming. Be Fairer Games, thank you so much. I appreciate you for coming. Kindly give me thumbs up. I'm sorry, I'm done with the topic for today, but you can watch a replay. So I'm talking about something different from my title, from my thumbnail, but you can always watch a replay. Thank you so much for coming. I appreciate. Oh, thank you for the thumbs up. You are so sweet. Oh, thank you. So yeah. 29 MC Atomic. Someone just came in. You can show him some love. He's gonna do the same thing. Show him some love. Watch his video. You know what to do. I always discuss this thing with my 12-year-old. I tell you the truth. Yeah, you need to start telling them, okay, when you see blood, don't be scared. You're not injured. You don't need to scream. You don't need to feel bad. It's normal. I see the same thing. Even when you are on your period, you wanna put your pad, you can call her to come in case I'm not at home. Exactly, preparing them ahead of time. In case I'm not at home, when you see your blood, you need to go and clean up. You need to do your pad like this, do it like this. This is where I keep it. You talk to them, you tell them, so they know. Not when they see you, they don't know what to do, they are scared. No. So they see you as their best friend. They can talk to you. They can talk to you. They can talk to you when they're in trouble. They can talk to you when they're difficult. Not like the story I shared in the video I did, Bad African Parenting. I did a video about that, Bad African Parenting. In Africa, we are scared of our parents. We don't fear our parents. Okay, no, we don't respect them. We fear them. And children are meant. I don't have kids. I'm not a good advisor. I don't have kids of my own. So I don't know many things about kids, but I have little experience about kids, because I've seen kids who have been abused. They bring them to the hospital for treatment. We try to talk to them. We try to counsel them. I have siblings. I've worked with kids, but I don't have kids of my own. I hope I'm able to apply, because kids are so delicate to take care of. I tell you the truth. I don't have kids, but I take care of kids. I know these things. So, you might not agree with me 100% with what I'm saying, but I think I'm just sharing my own experience and what I think is good. So, let me see. Someone just came in. Oh, thank you. Kicking it with Karen. Hello, Joy. Hope you're having a good. Oh, yes. I'm having a good day, and I appreciate the thumbs up. I love you so much, darling. Thank you so much for coming to my life. So if you're just coming, drop comment. I am so sorry. We are done. Oh, Zippy Brown, thank you so much for coming. Please kindly give me thumbs up. We are done with the topic, but you can watch a replay. Oh, I think everybody is doing fine. Oh yeah. So we are talking about something different. We've really treated the topic, so you can watch a replay later. Okay. So I think it is right. It is good for you to talk to them. And people put concentration on female children and feel like, oh, female children, they need home training. Male children need home training. Whoever think male children don't need home training, you see the men, the beasts who call themselves men, that beat their wives, I don't think they have proper home training. I don't think so. I don't think so. Some people, they teach them, but they decide to be beast on their own. Because a man who has home training would never beat a woman, no matter what the circumstances and situation may be. So you need to start teaching your male children to be responsible. Especially if you have both gender. If you have a male child, you have a female child. I think teach your male children how to be responsible with their sisters. Exactly. How to take care of female, how to address female, how to talk to female. Exactly, Feb Square. If you're opportune to have your children, they are two sex, you are lucky. Okay, it's good. Teach them. Let them know. Tell your brother, okay, tell the boy, okay, this is how you talk to your sister. You don't talk to your sister like that. Tell the girl, you need to respect him. He's a man. Okay, yes. Okay, you are the senior, he's the junior, but he's a man. Just show him some respect. He's the boy of the house, he's the father of the house. You know, tell them sweet words. They learn from there. Exactly, Zippy Brown. They learn from there. So when she gets married, she remembers, okay, since when I was small, my mom tell me, okay, the man is the head of the house, the man is a man, the man is the father, the man needs to be respected. She respects her husband. She respects him. And when it comes to the man, he knows, okay, oh, my mom, she always told me to care for my sister. You know, he goes to ask, have you eaten? Are you hungry? Oh, come, let's take a walk together. Let's go to the garden to play together. When he gets married, he have those things in the brain, in his brain. Exactly, MC Atonic. He tells his wife, oh, darling, can we just have a walk this evening together? Darling, have you eaten? Oh, let's go eat together because you push them to do it. You tell the boy, go and call your sister so we eat together. You know she's a female. They deserve some respect. Just go, go, go. He goes. You take it like it's a joke. You take it like it's not something important. But when they grow up, because even the Bible says, train a child the way they should go. And when they go, they will not depart from it. Children have very flexible brain. The thing you download in their brain is what they grew up to believe. So children believe a whole lot of false things because that is what our parents. I have a lot of belief as children. As a child, when I was growing, I have a different belief for tooth loss. When I came to Europe, I saw that my cousins they have different belief for tooth loss. You know, when children when their milk teeth pull off or pull out, they have a belief in Africa. In Europe, I have a video I did on that, but I don't know why I'm not uploading it. I have to do some editing. My belief, or rather, children's belief about tooth loss, or African children believe versus European children believe. We have two different beliefs when our teeth pull off. So it's what our parents have downloaded in our brain. That is what we make use of now. So it's very good. Teach your children. Don't say, oh, they are small. I don't need to talk to them about sex. No. Once they are 15, they are 16, they've started becoming attractive. Boys of 19, 20, 21, who thinks they are man enough, they want to have girlfriends. They will start hunting for your daughter. They start staying in the window, they start whispering. That's when your daughter will feel like, oh, I want to go to the library alone. I want to go to see my friend. I want to go to see this. If you don't tell them the truth, they might fall victim. So we really need to preach it. Tell them the truth. Tell them, okay, you are not supposed to do this. This is the right way to do. But everybody, especially when they are close to being adults, especially children in Europe, you know, once they are 18, they feel like, oh, I'm 18, I'm an adult. And they tell you, I'm an adult. So if my daughter tell me that, eh? That mouth she using telling me I'm an adult, eh? I tell you, I'm a very friendly person anyway. So I don't think I'm going to have stress with my kids. I pray so because kids are really, it's really stressful. Kids are difficult. You need to go to a different institution to know how to deal with kids. I tell you the truth. It's not easy. You need to be patient. You need to be friendly. You need to, you know, it's really not easy. But I pray to every mother, to every father that God help you in training your children because I tell you, children are difficult. And my boss, every day she tells me, Joy, don't make children. don't make children, like don't have children. Children are difficult. You see, I'm tired. Okay, thank you so much, Ify. Thank you so much. I appreciate you so much. And don't forget, we have people we want to work for tonight. So I've seen a lot of messages, but I'm live. I will soon go off so I can attend to those messages. Go and check. Do your check and know the people. So let's work hand in hand to grow the community. Okay, thank you so much. If you're just coming in, kindly give me thumbs up. We are done with the topic. You can go and check. Do a replay, I mean to say, so you meet up with the topic and what the thumbnail is saying. So that's just it. I think I've really tried today. I'm going to work tomorrow, and I still have a lot of things to do. I appreciate you guys so much for coming to my life. I'm blessed to have you guys in here, and I hope to see you guys again. So I'm gonna quickly say this before I go off. If you're coming to my live stream for the first time, please give me a thumbs up. If you are watching a replay and you manage to watch till the end, and you're not yet subscribed to my channel, kindly click the subscribe button and also give me a thumbs up. If you are watching the replay and you don't know anything about me, you are not used to me, you are seeing me for the first time, I do live stream almost every day, and I do my live stream most time in the evening or in the night rather. You can go to the channel description. You're going to see what I do on my channel, so you know what I do. You would not be surprised when you see a different video, and you'll not be like, oh, she was talking about health and now she's talking about YouTube growth. Oh, what's happening? You wouldn't be surprised. So guys, I think I have to go. Oh, thank you, Feb Square. Thank you. I really tried today. It's not easy. Thank you. I appreciate you guys for being here. We're going to catch ourselves up in the next one. So guys, let's just enjoy. Okay. Education, I'm going to answer you. My best color. I think that's the only thing I can remember out of. You can see my eyes are red already. I'm tired. Okay. My best color is any color. That's the truth, believe me. Yes, I love red. I love pink. I love orange. I love blue. I love yellow. I love every color. So I don't have a best color because I'm not a selective type. My best food is swallow. I love to swallow a lot, but I'm not selective. So I can eat anything. Even if I've not eaten it before, I can eat it. So I don't have best food. I love food. That's the only thing I can tell you. I love food. But I don't have a best food because I eat anything. I can decide to eat semo, 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 semo for 1 week. I can decide to eat rice for 1 week because I don't have problem. My life is not complicated. I don't have a best food. I'm so sorry. I don't have a best food. My favorite song is gospel music. I don't have a particular one. Gospel music. Because when I listen to gospel music, I'm inspired. It's easy for me to communicate with God. Sometimes when I want to pray, I start playing gospel music. When I start listening from there, I'm in the spirit. I start speaking in tongues. I start my prayer and I can pray like that for 2 hours. I can stay on my knees and pray for 2 hours. But it will all start with a song. It will inspire me. So I hope I answered your question. I hope so. I hope so. Edikesh, please answer me. Have I answered your question? Yes, I love all colors. Oh, thank you so much, CP Brown. Thank you so much. So I'm not a selective type. So that's why my life is not complicated. That's why I can cope in this world because I eat anything. I wear anything. I wear any color. I wear black. I wear pink, brown, red, any color. So, night, guys. We'll catch up. So, guys, I've seen millions of messages on my phone from the group. So I'm going to go and see that so we can still hang out in the group if you're not too tired. I know it's very late. Oh yeah. So I see you guys in my next one. Ciao. Good night. Oh yes, good night. Good night. Good night. Good night. Good night. So who else is gonna tell me good night? So you guys don't want to tell me good night. Really? Am I that bad? Anyway, I'm going. I'm going.